everyone. Happy Monday. It's a beautiful day out today. So I just wanted to briefly share something with you that I found really helpful and something that was really easy to do, but it was really, really nice. And I'm thinking about actually helping all of you guys do this, okay? Because I know that for a lot of us, Mercury retrograde can sometimes cause, of course, and you kind of bring a lot of distractions, a lot of unwanted energy. So I wanted to make sure that we can all be grounded, and by being grounded, by doing things the right way, by having the right approach and right energy, we can manifest greatness onto us. So what I had in mind was this little prayer box, okay? And normally, this is what it looked like, okay? One of them looked different, actually. But what I've done was, normally when I manifest something, I write it down, and this is when I want something to happen. I just let it go. But how do I maintain? So I maintain what I have by, you know, not worrying so much. You know, a lot of people pray and worry. And I thought that this would be a really cool tool for you guys to have. So, in other words, this is what I do. You know, it's something I've always done, but now that I found this, I'm going to use this tool. Okay? Everything that has ever come true for me, every blessing, every piece of abundance or prosperity, everything great that has come forward for me, that has worked out of my favor when the odds were against me, okay? I'm going to write those things down. Okay, so when I open this little box, okay, let's see if I can do it. When I open this little box, there's a pad here, okay? And this pad, basically, I can write down all of my blessings. It don't matter how many pages it was, but the most fundamental blessings that really change your life. So it doesn't really matter how big or small the blessing is, as long as it was something that was life-changing, okay? I write those down. And when I write them down, and I'm having a hard day, and I feel like giving up, and I feel like, you know, the universe has failed you, I feel like God has turned his back on me, I feel like I'm in this all alone, if I feel like lonely, and I feel like nobody understands me, if I feel like nobody really gets me at that moment, what I do is I go back to all those things, and it's a reminder of how wonderful the universe really is, and it helps me to be grounded, because instead of me worrying so much, thankful, because it's one thing to talk about your blessings, and it's one thing to share a testimony with the world, and to write a book, and to write a story or a poem, and all those things are great. But when you can actually reflect and go back and when you hold back and you look, you know, at all the things you made it through, and when you think about all that you accomplished, no matter how big or small it was, when you think about that tough time in your life, when you think about, wow, I can't believe, like, just a few years ago, I was, you know, homeless, or just, you know, a few years ago, I couldn't have children, and now look at me, you know, or, you know, I remember back then when I couldn't even get a car, when my credit was jacked up, like, whatever it was that the universe has allowed the doors to open for you, I want you to go back to that place, and I want you to just be grateful. And as you begin to be grateful, I promise you, my love, you have to keep up that trend. Continue to be grateful. Like I said, a lot of people pray and worry. It's impossible. You cannot pray and worry and claim that you are manifesting anything. If you are truly manifesting, you just know that you know that you know that you know. Like, I believe in my spirit. And when you think it's something about that, like when you really truly reflect, when you know that you know that you know that you know, nothing can stop you. I don't care if this is about money, children, family, you know, your career, whatever this is, you know. I'm telling you now my secret. The way that I manifest things and continue to hold on to abundance and prosperity is because I know that I know that I know. Nobody can tell me anything different. And this is not a religious thing, guys. This is just simply having faith in yourself first and having knowledge of self and not being afraid to go back and say, oh my God, I love who she used to be, because who she used to be taught me so much. Like, I love who I used to be. You know why? And I appreciate that, because it taught me a lot of things that I did not know at the time. And now that I look back, I'm like, you go, girl. You know, I can do that to myself. It feels good. And my last thing is to appreciate the small things.
Yes.
Yesterday I sat out here and I was like, oh my God, I love pine cones. I have a pine cone sitting in my home and it smells like, it reminds me of the holidays. It smells so good. And it's so, it's interesting to come outside and I saw this tree and I'm like, wow, this is huge, it's big. I love it. And I just love that it's pretty. And I looked up and it was pine cones everywhere. And I was like, I had no idea. Pine cones settle me. It settles my spirit. So when I saw it, I got super excited. So my whole point is learn to appreciate the small things. That is the biggest key to manifestation. Appreciating the small things in life. It's not always the big, flashy, materialistic things that come with it. It's the small things that's going to bring you your blessings. If you don't believe me, try it out for yourself. Get your pray box. Don't forget to manifest these great things. All the things that came to if you have a prayer box, even if you don't have this one, guys, you can create your own prayer box. Get like a little box or a shoe box, right? I don't know if you guys ever seen that movie War Room. I don't even know who movie it was by, but it was a really good movie. And one thing I picked up from that was all the notes around the room. She had a prayer room. She had a war room. She knew what to do. When she was facing hard times, she went to her prayer room. And she knew when she looked back at her life that she had everything to be grateful for and nothing to complain about. So I want to encourage you today to do the same, to get yourself a prayer box and to be reminded of all the good that has come your way during this Mercury retrograde. And I promise you, by the end of it, you're going to be truly blessed. She went inside. Love you guys.